I've said it then, and I'll say it now, I don't think there will ever be another Queer as Folk, even if there is another Queer as Folk. It'll never have the impact that this had.
No.
We were very aware that we had this one window in time, and we're very grateful that we were to be able to do this, because we knew a lot of people wouldn't have gone to the lengths that we did. And I'm very grateful for that. And I think it is part of gay and television history. It just is. I'm very proud of it.
I think it is part. As I said, I think if you, in the future, somebody wants to know what gay urban life was like in the United States at the turn of the 21st century, I think our show will be one of the documents of record. I believe that.
Well, we're speaking very seriously, but the thing about the show that always gets me is how entertaining it is, how funny and silly and political and dramatic, all these elements, which is very much our voice, and I think we brought that to that.
It was, always thought of it as a dramedy, that yeah. It was just as funny as it was serious.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And again, it was theatrical realism. You know, you could say it's over the top, but, you know, but we knew what we were doing. Of course it was bigger than life. It was supposed to be.
But, you know, I've never been in a room with gay men where there wasn't jokes and innuendos and sexual innuendos, and that's what we tried to bring to that.
I don't know.
And there was also, there's something very, to me, very charming and innocent about it all. Because I think we had a spectacular cast. They were very charming.
And committed.
And committed. And very attractive. And that was just providence. I mean, that was not, you know, we had very little to work with, and we wound up with a spectacular cast we couldn't be more grateful to.
Absolutely. I second that.
Thank you.
Excellent.
You're not going to rewrite that line?
No.
Okay, good.
Not a word.